Happy Tea Tuesday, everybody.
Hey, it's week three, and I'm actually keeping up with this. I'm actually really proud of myself, so yay.
Starting off, talking about the tea in the mug. So the tea that I'm actually drinking today, it's a new one for me. Well, newer. Is Mellow Peach Oolong. It's actually from a company in Colorado Springs called Silver Hawk Tea. One of my dear friends actually sent me a little care package a couple of weeks ago. Had some really tasty cookies and a handful of teas, and this was actually one of them, and I absolutely love it. It has a really good peachy taste to it, but it's really subtle in like the black tea type of taste, so it's really nice. Now, as for the cup, which hopefully you get to see the whole thing. This is actually the artwork from one of my dear friends. Gosh, I don't even know what you call yourself anymore. You keep changing it. She used to just be Aqua Droplet or Aqua Salt or something like that, or Salty Aqua. I don't know. She has a running joke about being in Salt Lake City and salt now. But Saffron, I still use this cup all the time, and I absolutely love it. She did the artwork of the Madoka characters, and then she actually got them put on a mug. They were a limited edition, which is hilarious because she was like, I'm going to stop producing them soon, so if you want them, and it, like, my payday was the next Friday, and I was like, just wait for next Friday, please, I'm placing an order. So she did, and I bought it, and then I was like, don't worry about shipping it, just get it to me. So it was actually a New Year's Eve gift for me. I was so happy to actually get it. But yes, absolutely love this. Love the tea as well. I'll put a link for the website because I think they do ship. If not, you could always talk to me and I can always mail it to you. Sorry about all of the pops and crackling noises that you hear. The cat has been jumping on all of the tables in the workshop. But huge announcement, lots of updates. I'm actually really excited about a lot of this stuff. That's why I put the tea down, so I have both my hands. Crystal Mountain Pony Con. It is next weekend. It's in Salt Lake City, Utah. I'll put a link into the information. But I actually found out that I'm going to be hosting two panels there. The first panel is going to be pony wigs. Basically what it is from bag to wow. So I'm going to just be pulling all of the main six wigs out of just a bag. So they've already been purchased. I haven't done anything to them. The most that I've done is washed them. And that's because I already styled a few of them. Oops. Anywho though, so I'm going to be doing that, and then I'm going to be styling them up front there so that you can actually watch them and learn how to do it. Hopefully, I'll be able to actually get these things recorded. I'm going to be bringing my camera and everything else, and I'm going to see if I could put them up there. If not, I might just try and do it again at another con or anything else like that. We'll just see what happens. But panel number two is actually Pony Cosplay 101. So I'm going to be going over the basics of cosplay and then how to kind of create My Little Pony characters as well. Again, I'm going to hopefully be able to record those. We'll find out. And then one more other kind of really awesome, cool thing, at least for me, is I was asked to judge the cosplay competition. So I will be one of the judges there. And I'm actually looking forward to this because I love being able to look at other people's costumes, see how people made them, and a whole bunch of other things like that. So I'm really excited. Two panels and a cosplay judging and Artist Alley on top of that. So don't forget, if you do go, if you want to come support me and my husband, if you want to get some etched mugs, patches, cosplay goodies, a whole bunch of other stuff, please come and visit our Artist Alley table. And if you want to just stop by and say hi, you know, just let me know, stop on by. If I'm not there, it's probably because I'm in one of the panels. So speak to my husband, say hi to him too, and then you can find out where I am at that point in time. But yeah, I'm actually really excited about this. I was a little bit overwhelmed at first because I found out about the panels last Friday, so it's like, oh, I've got 2 weeks to prepare and I'm still doing stock for the con. Ooh, goodness. So it was a little bit of a panic, but I am doing a lot better now. I'm almost done with my PowerPoint presentation, so whoop on that. But yeah, so that's one of the first big announcements for me, is that I'm just doing all of that stuff and I'm really excited about it. Now, I still have my asks open on my Tumblr, I still have my page open on Facebook, I even have, you know, the comments down below are still available too, so if you have any questions about anything, don't hesitate to ask me. I'm always around to help out. No, I did actually get two on my Tumblr this week, so I'm going to go ahead and answer both of them, because both of them are actually really good. So the first one actually came from Ask the PSP, which is a good friend of mine. She was actually the one that I was talking about last week. I don't remember what I was talking... No, the little teacup. She's the one that gave me the teacup. Ha! My brain does not work today. But she asked, will you do a video on how to clean your machine and general maintenance? So sewing machines and everything else like that. And yes, actually, I will have that posted later on this week. I'm going to be going over a huge overview of how to care for your machine, the do's and don'ts, easy cleaning stuff, and everything else like that. So PSP, expect that in the very near future, probably by Thursday this week. I should have it up for you. And the next question that I actually got, this was an anonymous, sorry, my tongue doesn't work. This was an anonymous question, and it was, any tips for first-time cosplayers? What should I look out for, real or wig or real hair? Buy, thrift, or make? And I love all of these questions, and some of these will actually be answered in any of the 101 panels that I actually create, but I'm just going to kind of give a quick overview. So, tips for first-time cosplayers. This is actually going to be kind of my personal thing, because a lot of cosplayers will tell you there are no rules for cosplay, just do what you want. However, after 13 years of cosplaying, I have actually learned that there's three guidelines that you need to follow by. Guideline number one, have fun. I know that sounds really weird, but you need to make sure that you are enjoying yourself while you're in your cosplays. You need to be able to smile and laugh. Even when you're making your costumes, it's so important that you have fun. Yes, there will be times where you sew pieces incorrectly or wigs don't go the way that you want them to, or different things like that, but even through those hard times, you still need to be able to laugh it off. And if you start realizing that you're no longer having fun in cosplays, out of cosplays, while making cosplays, you need to figure out why. You need to spend the time to sit down and go, okay, why am I not having fun anymore? What is affecting me so much that I am not enjoying this hobby? And depending on what the answer is, depends on what you do next. You either stop cosplaying or you fix the issue and keep cosplaying. And if you leave the cosplay world, it happens. It's another hobby. It does occur. Hopefully the friends that you made while you're cosplaying will understand and actually follow you and still be your friend afterwards. And if not, they weren't worth the time. I'm sorry. I'm just going to be blunt about that. Guideline number two, do not be the cause of someone no longer having fun. This goes in a lot of different ways. It goes from don't talk behind people's backs, don't talk about their costumes in a negative manner, don't give them grief, and do not tell them to stop cosplaying. One of the biggest things that I always hate seeing in this community, and I feel bad because I used to do this occasionally, not to the point of making people stop cosplaying, but I have at least been like, wow, you made that costume? Like, I didn't realize what I was saying at the time, but making it no longer fun for somebody else to cosplay is the worst thing that you can do, because you are harming a human being, and that does affect them in the future, and it affects how they feel and everything else like that. And the worst part is they will remember what you told them. I have seen people go, you know what, I still remember what somebody said to me 4 years ago, and that's why I've done better. But it's not in a positive manner, so do not be the cause of someone no longer having fun in this community. I know that's a dark, I know that that, like, my voice kind of changed a little bit, but it is because this is very personal for me. I have gone back and I have apologized to many people when I realized what I have done to them in the past, when I was like, yeah, that cosplay you made, wow, not nice, you know, type thing. I was like, you know what, I am so sorry for what I said. I did not mean it in that sense. I was just... I keep forgetting that everybody has a ground zero, and most of my friends, they are friends now, are like, oh no, I understood, but thank you for at least apologizing, and we've been able to talk a little bit better. So it is important that you have fun and that you're not the cause of someone else no longer having fun. Guideline number three, and I'm sure I could probably get a lot of people debating me about this one, but for me personally, this is how I feel. Make the character fit you, not you to the character. And what I mean by that is, if the character has a specific way that they wear their clothing, but you can't make that fit your body correctly, change it up so that your design will be able to fit you and the character as well. But don't feel like you have to change everything about yourself just to fit a specific character. You can actually change the character to fit you. A good point about this actually is when I built Neo Queen Serenity many, many years ago, she is a flatter chested character. I'm not flat chested. I am actually a very large, well-endowed chested woman. So instead of trying to flatten myself down, I actually put a corset on and then I built the costume around it so that I at least had some sort of comfort level, and I made sure that the character was a little bit more well endowed by doing that, but I also adjusted the costume to fit that view as well. I had one person that gave me grief about it, and I was like, I'm sorry, I'm not a B cup like she is, or I don't even know what type of cup she is, it doesn't really matter, but you know, I'm not going to try and compress myself either while trying to do that, because it would bother me more than being comfortable in what I'm wearing. So those are kind of three guidelines, at least for beginning cosplayers to think about. Have fun, don't be the cause of someone else no longer having fun, and make the characters fit you. So I know that I spent a little bit of time on that one, so that's kind of some basic tips, is just make sure that you're having fun. And Google is your best friend. Oh my goodness, I cannot emphasize this as much. If you are trying to work on a character, Google that character, add cosplay or cosplay tips, see what other people have done. Google is your best friend for that. Second part of the question is, what should I look out for? Like I just kind of said, look for tips, look for people that are willing to help you out, look for those type of things that'll help you progress and grow. Wigs or real hair? I am incredibly biased I'm not biased, I have learned from experience. Wigs are going to be 100% easier than your hair. At one point in time I tried to do, I'm talking about this one a lot, so maybe I should cosplay this one again, but Neo Queen Serenity, when I first did her, I bleached my hair blonde, and then we tried to put them in buns, and then we put hair extensions in. And you know, let's talk about this for a second. I have incredibly thin hair, so when we tried to do those buns, they were itty bitty, they were tiny. The bleach actually was yellow in the front and then blonde in the back. I got the nickname Big Bird for a while at my job. It was craziness. But it didn't look as good as a wig would have, because then, you know, you have the ability to also go from Neo Queen Serenity to Ryoko without having to worry about your hair not looking right. So I personally say go for wigs, and go through the wig tutorials that I've actually been going through in the past. You know, go over those, skim through them. They are actually really helpful. I've had a lot of people thank me for them. And then the last question was, buy, thrift, or make? The answer to that one is what you are comfortable with doing. If you want to purchase the costume, go right on ahead and do it. If you want to run to the thrift stores and a whole bunch of different stores and build the costume that way, go for it. If you want to go ahead and make your own, just go ahead and make your own as well. That is very much a possibility to do. So those are kind of my little tips about it all, and I will go over some more of them in the near future. But hopefully this kind of helps you guys out, and again, if you guys have questions, don't hesitate to ask me. Like, share, comment, blah, 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 blah. Sorry, I'm cutting this really short, but I'm hearing somebody knocking on my door. But hopefully I'll be able to see you guys in the future, and I hope to see a lot of you guys at Crystal Mountain Pony Con.